Hallelujah. Glory to God. Glory to God. Glory to God. Glory to God. This is the day that the Lord has made. We will rejoice and be glad in it. Glory to God. This is the day that the Lord hath made. We will rejoice and be glad in it. Glory to God. Glory to God. Glory to God. Praise God, strength and honor to everyone that is watching us today. We want to take this moment to welcome all of those who have joined us live by Facebook and by Zoom. Praise God that you have joined with us today. Amen. We want you to know that as we have gathered together around this medium of technology today, that this place becomes the sanctuary of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, that this is the place where we gather together to lift up and exalt the great name of Jesus. For the Lord is good and his mercy endure forever. Hallelujah. And God has blessed us to see the breaking of a brand new day. It's a new day in God. Hallelujah. Not only is this August, praise God, the eighth month. Amen. Which means eight means new beginning. Praise God. I want you to know as God has brought us through what we call night, the season of night, into the day. Praise God. I want you to know that this is a new day and a new time in God. So we want to celebrate the Lord today. Hallelujah. Praise God. Before we go forth and pray, I want to read this psalm from out of Psalm 24. Praise God. It says, the earth is the Lord's and the fullness thereof, the world and they that dwell therein. For he hath founded it upon the seas and established it upon the floods. Who shall ascend to the hill of the Lord, or who shall stand in his holy place? He that hath clean hands and a pure heart, who have not lifted up their soul unto vanity, nor sworn deceitfully, he shall receive the blessing from the Lord and righteousness from the God of his salvation. This is the generation, glory to God. This is the generation of them that seek him, that seek thy face, O Jacob. Lift up your heads, O ye gates, and be ye lift up, ye everlasting doors, and the King of glory shall come in. Glory be to God. Glory be to God. Who is the King of glory? He is the Lord of hosts. He is the King of glory. Praise God. Glory to God. And I want you to know that today is the day of a lifting up. Praise God. No matter where you are, no matter what this week has been, glory to God, this is the moment of the lifting up. Praise God. This is the moment to lift up your head. Glory be to God. It's a brand new day. Hallelujah. Lift up your head, open up your eyes, and look out and see. It's a brand new day in God. Praise God. Praise God. So at this time, I'm going to ask Prophetess Karen McCray if she would lead us in prayer this morning. And praise God, as she prays and as she leads us in prayer, I want you to just begin to pray as well. Amen. And begin to bless the name of the Lord of our God of our salvation. Glory to God. Glory to God. Shurakataya.
Oh, Lord, our Lord, how excellent is thy name in all the earth. Oh, Lord, our Lord, how great and how majestic is thy name in the heavens and the earth. Oh, Lord, our God, how marvelous and how wonderful is thy name, and your name, O God, is greatly to be praised. Father God, we come now in the name of your Son, Jesus the Christ. We come to give glory, we come to give praise, we come to give thanks. We come with humble hearts and adoration on this first Sunday in the calendar month of August. God, we thank you for this day, and we thank you for life. We thank you for strength. We thank you for health. We thank you for the joy of you, dear God, which is our strength. We bless you, Almighty God, who has created the heavens and the earth. The earth is yours. The heavens is yours. Everything moves by your power. And God, we recognize this today, and we acknowledge that you and you alone are God. And God, we just give you praise. Thanks be unto you, God. It's because of you that today, God, we have victory. It's because of you, God, that today we are more than conquerors through Christ Jesus. It's because of you, God, our creator, that the creation is able to cry out hallelujah and amen. For you are the God of hosts. You're strong and mighty. Who is like unto you, our God? There is no God like Jehovah. There is no God like you. And God, we bless you this morning. God, we just give you thanks this morning. Hallelujah to the Lamb of God that was slain for the sins of the whole world. Blessings and glory and honor be unto you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And so, God, as we come today, assembled through this means of a virtual fellowship, God, we are yet coming together, even though we're in various places. Our hearts and our minds and our being are coming together as one, dear God, because we understand that when we are one mind and one faith, and when we're on one accord, you will come into our midst. So, Father God, though we're in separate homes, today we come as one mind, as one body, as one child, dear God. And we ask you to forgive us, Lord, of sins we have committed in thought, word, or deed. We ask you, Lord, to plant us now, hallelujah, like we've never been planted before, and dip us, Lord, and wash us in the blood of Emmanuel, and hear our voices today as we cry out through the blood, holy, 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 Lord God Almighty, earth and heavens are filled with thy glory. We rejoice in you, and we give you glory. Hallelujah. We come as one before you, holy and righteous God. We come as one giving you praise. We come as one giving you glory. We come as one, hallelujah, asking you, Lord, to hear the cries of your children in this hour. God, we come now asking you, God, to feed us with manna from on heaven. God, we come now telling you, God, that our ears are attuned to heaven. Our eyes are on you. We come with an expectancy, God, because we need to hear from the sovereign and righteous God today. God, we come now as fertile ground, hungry for the fertilizer of your word and the refreshing waters of you, God. We come now before you, holy God, looking for strategies of how we're to operate in this month, how we're to go day by day. We're looking for you, God, for more deliverance, God. We're looking to you, God, for healing waters. We're looking for you, for your Holy Spirit, God, to come. We're looking for your glory. We're coming with expectation, looking and listening. And God, today we give you praise for hearing our prayers and answering through the portals of glory, giving us answers, giving us direction, healing and delivering, making us free. And God, we give you praise now. We give you thanks right now for what you shall speak, what you shall do, and how you shall work in us. Speak through the speaker, Lord Jesus. Crown her with your glory. Command the words from her mouth today. And we, God, your children, sit now, listening with the posture of expectation that we will hear clearly from you today. God, we bless you and we give you all the glory. And the people everywhere who are listening, lift up your voice and shout hallelujah and amen to the holy and righteous one. In the name of Jesus, the only begotten Son of God, we say this prayer and we count it done. Amen and amen and
Shelapasurakataya. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Glory to God. I want to ask, amen, wherever you are, praise God. Amen. I want you to just take this moment to begin to open up your mouth and give God praise. Hallelujah, hallelujah. The Bible says, wherever two or three are gathered together in my name, he promised to be there. So as we are gathered, amen, together in the name of the Lord, I want you to know that he is in the midst of us. Glory to God. So just take this moment and begin to give God praise. Glory be to God. Blessed be the name of the Lord our God. From the rising of the sun to the going down of the same, the name of the Lord is to be praised. Great is the Lord. Hallelujah, and greatly to be praised in the city of our God and in the mountain of his holiness. He is beautiful for every situation, and he is the joy of all the earth. Come on, you and I are the earth as well. Come on, and he is the joy of you and I. Come on, if he's the joy of your soul, the lover of your soul, come on, lift up your head. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Rukatataya, hallelujah. Come on, just lift up, hallelujah, your head. As your head is lifted up, amen, let your voice be lifted up. Let your heart be lifted up today. Come on, give him great praise today. Hallelujah. The psalmist declares, he said, sing unto the Lord all the earth. Proclaim his salvation or deliverance day after day. Come on, today we purpose to proclaim the deliverance and the salvation of our God. Declare his glory among the nations. Glory be to God. His marvelous deeds among all the people. He says, for great is the Lord and greatly to be praised. He is to be feared above all gods. For all the gods of the nations, come on, this is loud declaration as a believer. All the gods of the nations are nothing but idols. Come on, Rakataya, we serve the true and living God. It is the Lord our God, Jesus Christ, who have made all the heavens and the earth. Come on, we decree it today. Splendor and majesty are before him. Strength and joy are his dwelling place. Ascribe unto the Lord, all ye nations of the earth. Ascribe to the Lord glory and strength. Glory be to God. We bless the name of the Lord today. We bless the name of the Lord today. Hallelujah. Lift up your head, all ye gates. Be ye lifted up, ye everlasting doors. And the King of glory shall come in. Who is the King of glory? He's the Lord God, strong and mighty. He's the Lord God, mighty in battle. Hallelujah. Come on, I want you to know, as you are praising the name of the Lord our God, hallelujah, the mighty, he is the mighty man of war. He is Jehovah Gabor, the mighty man of war that goes before us. Praise God, as the warrior king, praise God, and breaks forth through every work of darkness. Glory be to God. Praise ye the Lord. Praise ye the Lord. Praise ye the Lord. Let everything that have breath praise ye the Lord. I want you to know that as you give him praise, not just from emotion, but give him praise from revelation, because you know who he is. I praise him because he's my deliverer. I praise him because he's my healer. I praise him because he's my keeper. I praise him because he's my protector. I praise him because he sets a table before me in the presence of every enemy. I praise him because it is he who hath anointed my head with oil and caused my cup to my hoshaya, it to koshkataya. And behold, all that men would praise the Lord. Hey, shola behold. Oh, that men would praise the Lord for his mighty works toward the children of men. Hallelujah. Now, come on, don't let me praise him by myself. Glory. I'm telling you, our God is a strong God. He's a strong God. He's strong. He's mighty. He's glorious in holiness. He's fearful in praise. He's still doing miracles. He's still working wonders. He's the God of wonders. Yeah. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. I make no apologies. I give God praise because he's glorious. Listen, the seasoned saints say, you don't know like I know what the Lord has done for me. You can't tell it like I can tell it. I'm telling you, he brought me up out of a horrible pit. And I will praise the name of the Lord forever. Hallelujah. For the Lord is good. He is good. And his mercy endure forever. Let the redeemed of the Lord say so, whom he had redeemed. And I want you to know that you and I, who have been redeemed and purchased by the precious eternal blood of Jesus Christ, we got a song to sing that even the angels that are around the throne right now can't sing. Come on here, somebody. The Bible in Revelation talks about how that there was a number that could not be numbered. It said, who are these? These are those whose robes have been washed in the blood of the Lamb. Glory be to God. Of every nation, every tongue, every tribe, every kindred. Glory be to God. Every cultural expression, giving God praise and glory. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. I don't know about you. Amen. I refuse to let any rock or anything else cry out for me. Hallelujah. Glory to God. God invested a work in me that provoked a praise, and he's going to get the praise from the work that he produced in me. Hallelujah. How about you? Glory be to God. He's worked a wonder in your life. Glory be to God. And let me just tell you something. There are things that God did for you that you have no clue that God was working things out on your behalf. Hallelujah. The Bible, God, the word the saints used to say, he kept us from danger seen and unseen. There were things that you were oblivious to, but the hand of God was working on your behalf. I feel the glory this morning. Mokoshila paya. Come on, somebody. You're spending time looking at what you could see. But I want you to begin to give God praise for what you did not see. God kept you from it. Makasataya. He kept your child from it. He kept your father from it. He kept your mother from it. He kept your daughter from it. Glory be to God. He kept your aunt. If it had not been for the Lord who was on your side, your enemy would have swallowed you up. But thanks be unto God who has given you the victory through Christ Jesus. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. I purpose in my heart, I will praise God forever through whatever. Hallelujah. Because he is our King. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Hallelujah. I'm telling you, I'm trying to calm down. But I'm telling you, it's something about when you begin to think about the good. There's anointing that comes upon you when you start thinking. Yes, Lord. There's an anointing that comes upon you when you start thinking. Because the moment you start thinking about the goodness of the Lord, your mouth got to activate. Your mind can't just think about the goodness of the Lord and your mouth be dormant. No, sir. When you begin to think about the goodness of the Lord and what God has done, those thoughts about the goodness of the Lord will activate your mouth, and your mouth will begin to praise the name of the Lord our God, for he is good. Not was, he is good. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. He is good. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. All right, I'm going to try to move on, but I'm telling you, I feel the glory this morning. Praise God. You watching us by way Facebook, let me tell you something. From this day forward, listen, always purpose that wherever you are is a sanctuary to give God praise. Glory be to God. And I'm going to tell you something. We talk about the miracles and the signs and the wonders. Amen. But I'm telling you that we are walking in that hour right now. Glory to God. Glory to God. Where it is no longer a prophetic declaration. It is now a prophetic manifestation. But God is causing his word, amen, to manifest. He said in Luke 1:46, there shall be a performance of the word, of his word. And I'm telling you now that God is performing his word. He's performing it. He's performing it. Glory be to God. Don't stagger at what you see around you, because let me tell you something. When the word start manifesting, it don't initially look like what you thought, but it is the word of the Lord manifesting. Hallelujah. He is hastening. Praise God. And let me just release this. I just heard this in my spirit to somebody watching me by Facebook. I heard the word of the Lord from out of Jeremiah. Amen. Jeremiah chapter 1, verse 12. He says, I'm going to hasten to perform my word. And I hear the spirit of the Lord saying to you that I am moving now. There is an anointing of acceleration that's coming on the word of the Lord that God has been speaking to you. And I want you to receive this word from the Lord. Amen. God says, no longer is it delayed. He says, now I'm hastening to perform my word, and you're going to see it. Glory to God. You're going to see it shortly. Praise God. So whoever that's for, amen, rejoice in the Lord. Amen. Rejoice in the Lord, because the word of the Lord is going to be hastened. The enemy's been fighting you, telling you it's going to be delayed. It's not going to happen. But the Lord said, no, as a matter of fact, I'm going to hasten. There's an anointing of acceleration coming. Praise God. Amen. Glory to God. At this time, amen, I'm going to ask Minister Olin if he would lead us in a song of praise. Amen. Praise God. Amen. Before I take off, amen, and get the lifting off, amen. Praise God.
Hallelujah. You have won the victory. Hallelujah. You have won it all for me. Death could not hold you down. You are the risen King. seated in majesty. You are the risen King. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You have won the victory. Lift your voice and say, hallelujah. You have won it all for me. Death, death could not hold you down. You are the risen King, seated in majesty, seated in majesty. You are the risen King, you are the risen King. Our God is risen, our God is risen, he is alive. He won the victory. He reigns on high. Our God is risen. He is alive. He's won the victory. He reigns on high. Our God is risen. He reigns on high. He's won the victory. He reigns on high. Our God is risen. He reigns on high. He runs the victory. He reigns on high. Hallelujah. He has won the victory. Lift your voice and say, hallelujah. He has won it all for me. Death could not hold you down. You are the risen King, seated in majesty. You are the risen King. You are the risen King. Death, death could not hold you down. You are the risen King. You are the risen King. Seated in majesty. Seated in majesty. You are the risen King. You are the risen King. Hallelujah. You have won the victory. Lift your voice and say, hallelujah. You have won it all for me. Hallelujah, Lord.
Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. My God, my God. Our God is risen. He is alive. He won the victory and he reigns on high. Praise God. That is our declaration this morning. Praise God, and every morning. Praise God that our God is risen. He is alive. He won the victory and he is reigning on high. No matter what happens in our world, our God is still on the throne, reigning and ruling over the affairs of men. Praise God. Praise God. Thank you, Minister Olin. Praise God for that psalm of praise. Glory be to God. We are excited today at what the Lord is doing. Amen. God's doing wondrous things in our day and time. Praise God. And the psalmist declares, and that my soul know it right well. Amen. So we're excited this morning. Amen. We're getting ready to receive the word of the Lord this morning. Praise God. And so this morning we have with us one of our spiritual daughters, Evangelist Vontrese Carstens, who is going to be sharing the word of the Lord with us today. Amen. Praise God. So as she comes, amen, we want you to receive her. Amen. In the spirit of the Lord. Amen. As she comes to share the word of the Lord, let your heart be open to hear. Let your heart be open to receive. Your ears be open to hear. The Bible says faith comes by hearing, and hearing by the word. Amen. So as we prepare to hear the word of the Lord, amen, I'm asking you to receive today, amen, Evangelist Vontrese Carstens, amen, as she shares with us the word of the Lord.
Amen. Amen. Good morning, everybody. I'm just so grateful and honored to be with family. It's nothing like when you can just come and be with your family. You know, I know everybody here, you know, loves me and, you know, just embraces me. So it just feels good when you got it, when you have to bring the word and you can bring the word before your family. So I'm grateful. I'm actually excited about it. Usually I'm like really, really, really nervous, but I feel good. I feel loved and I feel good. So I'm just grateful for that. So I just want to honor and celebrate my family, all my family at Katie and Mai. So thank you. I also would like to first and foremost honor God for this opportunity to bring forth his word today. And I also like to give honor to my husband, Keith, who was not able to be on today because he had other obligations, but I know his love is with me. And I would like to honor Apostle Jay, my spiritual parents, and Pastor Natalie Thompson for giving me this opportunity to speak the word of the Lord today. So I'm grateful. I'm excited. Since I'm with family, y'all can feel comfortable to drop some comments in the comment box to let me know y'all with me. We're going to be real interactive today. All right, okay? Because I know we can't unmute, but at least, you know, we can be engaged with the word. So just feel free to do that. And before I go any further, I just want to go before the Lord in prayer, and then we will get right into the word. Amen. So Father, I just thank you for allowing me this opportunity to speak to your people. God, I count it not robbery, Lord God, to share the word today. And Father, I declare, God, that every ear will be open, God, to hear this word, God, that every heart will be open to receive. God, I pray, God, that you will prepare our hearts this morning, God, to hear what it is that you want to say to us. God, I pray that this word will be life, that it will activate our faith, that it will encourage us, Lord God, to continue about this week, that it will encourage us, God, to continue throughout the rest of this year, God, in your will, in the name of Jesus. God, we come against every hindrance, God, from receiving this word today. God, let this word fall on good ground, God, and we'll be mindful to give your name the glory, the honor, and the praise. And it is in Jesus' mighty name that we pray. Amen. Amen, y'all. So the topic that the Lord gave me for this message today is called Seize the Moment. Seize the Moment. And he actually gave me this word 2 weeks. I think it was about 2 weeks ago. I heard it so clear in my spirit. So I believe that this is a word from the Lord. So seize the moment. And we're going to be coming from 1 Corinthians 16 verse 19. It's a very short scripture. And so, and it reads, again, it's 1 Corinthians 16, chapter 16, verse 19, and it reads, "For a great door, an effectual one, is open unto me, and there are many adversaries." I'm going to read the scripture again so we can receive it, right? So it says, "For a great door, an effectual, is open unto me, and there are many adversaries," okay? And so in this text, this is Paul. In 1 Corinthians, this is a letter that the Apostle Paul is writing to the church at Corinth. And he's writing to the church about his plans to stay in Ephesus until Pentecost. And so he's letting them know his travel plans. He's like, listen, I'm letting y'all know now I'm going to be in Ephesus until Pentecost. And the reason that I'm here is because a great door, an effectual, is open unto me. But he says there are many adversaries. Now, I don't know if you guys know any information about the city of Ephesus, but the city of Ephesus was an important Greek city. It was known for its pagan worship and their worship of this goddess, this sex goddess named Diana. And so if you can just put your mind how the region was, how the climate was, this region was, it was overcome by a lot of darkness. This region wasn't open to the truth of the word of God. And so in Acts, the scriptures record that was Paul's first time in Ephesus. And so he had begun during that time to preach and teach against these false gods. He began to teach and preach against the wicked climate in Ephesus, right? And so during his time there, the gospel began to disrupt the economy. So when he began to preach and teach the gospel, there were some silversmiths there, right? And so as he began to speak out against these false gods and against their idols, he started messing with the silversmith's money. And so sometimes when we begin to speak the truth, right, and we begin to declare the word of God, something shifts, something happens, even with the economy, even with the money, it starts uncovering darkness and where people was benefiting off of people. Because one thing about darkness, there's a group of people that benefit from people being in darkness. There is sometimes even our economy benefits from people being blinded, right? And so these silversmiths was like, wait, he is messing with our money, because they would make these images, they would make these idols out of silver, the idols of Diana, the goddess Diana. They would make these idols, and so they were like, they're messing with our money. So as a result of that, a riot broke out, and they were like, wait, we can't have Paul preaching, we can't have him preaching this message. And so because of that riot, Paul's first time in Ephesus, his ministry there was cut short, right? Because this riot broke out. And so Acts records that there was a great deal of opposition, which placed Paul in great danger. And so Paul had to flee from Ephesus. He wound up leaving, right? And so now in 1 Corinthians, Paul is now writing and saying, listen, even though I left, I was disappointed. And I believe that Paul, this work was so important to Paul that it literally, I feel like it was near and dear to his heart. Paul prayed about this work and he really wanted the gospel to be preached in that region. And so Paul began to pray and he began to ask God, I believe, to give him Ephesus, to have Ephesus to fall to the gospel, to the gospel's message. And so Paul wound up waiting 3.5 long years for this extremely pagan city to open up wide for him to preach the gospel. And so Paul left and he waited 3 years. And finally, the resistance and the opposition he experienced during his first visit there, it was crumbling, right? And the city was responding to the gospel. And when Paul is describing this opportunity, he calls it, he says, and a great door, an effectual, is open unto me. Now, Paul is writing about this door, right? And so when we think a door in scriptures, usually in scriptures, when they talk about a door is usually describing an opening of a region, right? It's usually describing the opening of a region to hearing the gospel's message. And we see this recorded in 2 Corinthians. We see this recorded in Colossians 4:3 about describing this door. And so Paul not only calls this opportunity, and he don't just call it any opportunity or any door. He says that this door is a door, but it is effectual, right? And so for an apostle, this is an apostle's dream, right? An apostle wants people, I know our apostle, he wants people to hear this gospel's message. He wants, hallelujah, for us to receive the word of the Lord. And so this was an apostle's dream for an entire region to be open to the word of the Lord. And so darkness at this time was being driven out. Amen. And the gospel, you know, was being preached. So Paul said, I'm going to stay here until Pentecost, right? And so revival began to happen. And historically, It was noted that because of this opportunity, that this literally was, this formed one of the largest churches in the first century. And so imagine how major this opportunity was. It wasn't just that he went there for opportunity to preach, but that this literally formed one of the largest churches in the first century. And so that's one heck of an opportunity, right? This opportunity was unique. Paul had complete access, and this will be noted to be one of his greatest works, right? And so this opportunity was unique because it wasn't just any door, but it was an effectual door. And so I looked up the word effectual, right? The word effectual comes from the word energy, and it describes something that is forceful, effective, active, and powerful. And so this literally door was effective, right? So another definition for effective is it also means something that is successful in producing a desired outcome or result. And so sometimes when we think about doors, right, we all get opportunities. We may get opportunities to do something, right? But it's a difference when what you're doing is effective. You can preach before 2,000 people and nobody gets saved. So yeah, you was able to walk through the door, but the door wasn't effectual, right? It didn't produce the intended outcome. So Paul was saying that I'm not staying in Ephesus because I've been given an opportunity. A lot of us, we jump at opportunities, but we got to jump at the right opportunities. We got to jump at the opportunities that are powerful. We got to jump at opportunities that are effective, and it's going to produce the intended outcome. When God describes his word, he says, my word performs that which it has been sent out to do. And so in this hour and in this season, we got to pick up the work. Hallelujah. We got to be intentional about our doors, because if it's not going to produce the intended outcome, what's the reason that we're doing it for? And so Paul was like, he was trying to let them know that this is not just any door. This door is effectual. This door literally has given me access, hallelujah, and not just any access, but I'm going to be effective through this access, that this access is literally going to produce the intended outcome. And so this was different than the first time, right? So not saying that Paul wasn't productive the first time, but I believe the anointing, the power of God, this was the set time. And as Apostle was talking about earlier, and he hit on it, he said this is the set time, right? So I believe that this was a time that God intended, because now Paul was not just doing this work alone. He had Aquila, he had Priscilla, right? They were all teaming together. He had Apollos. They were all teaming together to complete this work. So this was what Paul waited for. This is the expectation, hallelujah, of the assignment. He said, this city is giving way to me. So he was saying that this is a door of opportunity. But I want us to know as believers what Paul said accompanied this door, right? And so sometimes we stop right there. We stop at this is effectual. You know, God has sent me to do this. I know God sent me to this job. I know he sent me to this school. I know he sent me, hallelujah, to preach to my family. I know he has sent me, hallelujah, to do this work. But a lot of times we stop at the opportunity, or we get excited about the door. But Paul noted, he said, something accompanies an effectual door. There is a DNA, hallelujah, that accompanies a particular assignment that has been ordained by heaven. And he says, what accompanies this door is many adversaries. He says, many adversaries. He said, yeah, this door has opened up to me. Yes, I have this opportunity to preach the gospel. Yes, I had this opportunity to go and to stay in Ephesus. But he said, but this opportunity also has many adversaries. And he says, and I'm not blinded, hallelujah, to the opposition that accompanies this door. And a lot of times as people of God, when God begins to open doors for us, when oppor- opportunity knocks on our doors, right? And we expect everything to go smoothly. We think we won't have any trouble. We think we won't have any hardship. Hallelujah. We think we won't experience any failure. But Paul declared, this opportunity, hallelujah, has many adversaries. God's word also tells us that that's farthest from the truth. And so what God began to say to me about even this time that we're in, we have to, sometimes we throw in the towel because we are experiencing opposition or circumstances and situations are not ideal or they seem to not be advantageous to the intended outcome. But God is saying that is the recipe for to do what I want to do in the earth. He says that opposition literally is almost like my it's almost like the evidence that my hand is on something, right? And so when the great and effectual door is open, when the potential is there to be really used by God, when the potential is there for God to really be put on display, when the potential is there for us to really, hallelujah, put God, hallelujah, on center stage and be blessed, there is not only few, but there are many adversaries that will try to stop the plan and the will of God. He says, I want my people to understand that there will be opposition, there will be circumstances, there will be situations that will try to stop what I want to do in the earth, hallelujah, through your life and through the life of his, and through the assignment of his church, hallelujah. And there's a human tendency to look at opposition and problems as a sign that you are doing something wrong. Sometimes, you know, the world teaches us if things are not going in our favor, if things are not going the way that we intended for them to go, then that is a sign that we are doing something wrong. But I came to declare this morning to the people of God, allow opposition to be the sign and to be the vehicle that you are on the right page, that you are in the right time, that you are born in the right season, hallelujah, to bring the glory of God to earth. As the apostle declared this morning, that this is the time for signs, that this is the time for miracles, that this is the time for wonders. And because we are looking at, hallelujah, the opposition, we think that it is time for us to draw back. Just because we are not able to gather in a physical building, God's church is still supposed to be on the move, because this is the effectual time. This is the set time, hallelujah, for the people of God to go forth. So God said, we need to break out, hallelujah, of that mindset. That is a mindset, hallelujah, that is in opposition to the plan and the will of God. Hallelujah. So we need to do inventory on our minds this morning. What thought process, what lens are we looking out of? Because Paul said, even though, and one thing I love about it, he didn't say that he didn't say that any great and effectual door has opened unto me, but there are many adversaries. He said there's a great and effectual door that has opened unto me, and there are many adversaries. But cancel is out. Hallelujah. The thing that was said before it. But Paul said that the opposition still does not cancel the plan and the will of God. We got to understand that the opposition does not have, hallelujah, it does not have the intensity. It does not have the power to cancel out what God has spoken. What God declared in the beginning of 2020, he is still declaring. What God spoke over our lives, what God has spoke over this ministry, it is the what has preceded before it, preceded after it, does not have the power to cancel out what God has said. He said that his word will perform that which it has been sent out to do. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I remember I remember tracing over my life as a little girl, and every time that there would be something for me to celebrate or something that was happening for me, it seemed like there was opposition. I mean, every graduation, my fifth grade graduation, my eighth grade graduation, my 12th grade graduation, it was almost seemed like the enemy was trying to rob me. I mean, all hell was breaking loose in my family. All hell was breaking loose in my life. Hallelujah. And it seemed like, I was like, what is happening? Have you ever had a time of celebration? Have you been at one of the most, hallelujah, times of your life? Prayer is being answered. And then all hell start breaking loose with your children. All hell start breaking loose in your home, right? And it seems like even things start going out of whack with your health. And you like, what is happening? What is God? Now, I know I heard you clearly. It sometimes it even happens when people are having babies, when people are getting married, everything start going on with the family, things start becoming out of whack with your finances. That's that opposition that he was talking about. That's that opposition. I even remember, you know, I'll be coming up on 1 year of marriage, and out during my wedding season and process, and I'm like, Lord, I know I heard you clearly. I know that, you know, this is what I'm supposed to be doing. And then it seemed like y'all, all hell was breaking loose. I was like, people I didn't even expect. Hallelujah. Just started just doing a whole 180. I'm like, what is going on? But that was a sign. Hallelujah. That this was the plan and the will of God. And so I wrote down that God says for mature believers, I'm not talking about the immature, but for mature believers, opposition should be a sign that it is the evidence of the impact of the door that we are getting ready to walk in. The level and the intensity of the opposition should show us, hallelujah, of the impact, hallelujah, of the door that we are walking through. Is getting ready to literally be in the earth. Hallelujah. And at any time, y'all, that we find ourselves standing before a red door of opportunity, the enemy will appear on the scene with an attempt to steal this divine moment of opportunity for the people of God. And so even when I talked about with my wedding, the enemy was trying to take the joy out of it. He was trying to literally steal the joy of the opportunity. But God says, we got to begin to set our mind on the things above. We got to begin to look to the hills from which cometh our help, for our help cometh from the Lord. We cannot begin to look out and seeing what is befalling the earth and seeing what's happening in our world. God says, I don't care what CNN says. I don't care what the news says. I don't care what the rates are for COVID-19. This is still the set time for my church. This is still the time that I want to arise and shine upon my people. This is still the set time that I'm going to bless your business. This is still the set time that I'm going to bless Katie and I. Do not look at what's happening in our world. Do not look at what's happening, hallelujah, on your job. Hallelujah. I've been blessed so much during this time. I got an email last week and it said, now they told us at work we would not be given any raises because we couldn't afford it. Our hospital was going under. We had tried to merge with a larger healthcare system, and the government stopped it. And they said this will be a monopoly. We cannot allow you to merge. And so already our institution was already stretched. We were all financially, we cannot afford to not survive any other time, but definitely not during a pandemic. And so they told us you would not be able to get nobody in the healthcare network will be able to get a raise. But let me tell y'all, on last week we got a message from the president of the hospital, and he said we have received X amount of dollars, and every employee will receive a 3% raise. Now that may not be nothing for you, but when man says it is impossible, God says this is still the set time that I'm going to bless you. And I believe that healthcare network is blessed because a believer is there. God didn't send me there, hallelujah, to be overcome by poverty. And then right before that, y'all, they furloughed me. They told me to go home. And my coworker said, are you okay? I said, yes, I'm okay. Because God didn't bring me here to leave me. Even if they tell me not to return, hallelujah, this is still the set time for me to be blessed. And unemployment wound up setting me up to be blessed.
Sometimes we look at the opposition. If we're not careful, if we're not praying, if we're not in the spirit, we will let the opposition, hallelujah, cause us to curse our season. This is still the set time for us to be blessed. This is still the set time that God is going to get the glory and the honor out of our life. Hallelujah. God says, look again. Look again. Hallelujah. He says, I need my people to look again. I've allowed this pandemic to be a recipe for a great and effectual door for my church. Hallelujah. So we have to shift our thinking, and we have to lay for this hour. I know we are seeing, because one thing, when I talked about the enemy trying to steal the moment, the enemy, he can't create anything, so he tries to steal what God has set up to be a blessing to us. He has tried to set up racism to steal what God is trying to do through us. He has allowed, hallelujah, he has tried to cause sickness to steal what God wants to do through us. Hallelujah. He has tried to allow death to steal what God is trying to do through his people. Hallelujah. But this is still the set time. This moment is still advantageous for the gospel to be preached. So God is declaring to us today, seize the moment, seize the moment, seize the moment, seize the moment. What does it mean to seize the moment? It means to take full advantage of the opportunities. The devil is taking full advantage. The people of God should take full advantage. Hallelujah. Seize the moment. Seize the moment. And then we need a reminder. He said, upon this rock will I build my church, and the gates of hell shall not prevail against it. The enemy don't have nothing, hallelujah, in his arsenal that will prevail against his church. Not sickness, not disease, hallelujah, not racism, hallelujah, not poverty, nothing, hallelujah, will be able to prevail against the work and the plans of God. The plans of God are yes and amen. They are still yes and amen. In the midst of a pandemic, they are still yes and amen. With things being uncovered, the plans and the will of God is still yes and amen. God is causing these circumstances, he's allowing these circumstances that are befalling our world to work for our good. Hallelujah. Would Joseph declare, he said, what you meant evil against me, but God used it for my good. So many things come up against us that seem evil. And sometimes they are evil, but God is able to make it work for our good. Hallelujah. Somebody put in the comments, seize the moment. Now is the time to seize the moment. Hallelujah. And one thing our apostle did, I remember he told me in the beginning, before I even got engaged, he was talking about moments. Moments. Moments come and moments go. Hallelujah. So that's why it's important to seize it. We may never get a moment like this. The heavens may never be open like this. So we got to seize the moment. Hallelujah. God is not obligated to say again what he said in a previous season. So now is the time. Now is the set time for us to seize the moment. Hallelujah. And the scripture our apostle loved is Isaiah 60. And it says, arise and shine, for your light has come, and the glory of the Lord rises upon you. Katie Amai, the glory of the Lord is rising upon you. See, darkness covers the earth, and thick darkness is over the people. Hallelujah. But the Lord rises upon you, and his glory appears over you. Hallelujah. And I want to declare this. I'm out of Isaiah 60. It says, as nations will come to your light. This is a time for nations to come to our light. This is the time that kings, hallelujah, will come to our light. This is the time that kings, hallelujah, will inquire about our wisdom. Hallelujah. So I prophesy tonight, today, that nations will come to our light. I prophesy today that princes will come to our light and seek out our counsel. I prophesy that this is the set time. The time is now. And before Apostle even declared that the time is now, I had it written. The time is now. But we have to lay hold to what God is doing in this hour and what God is doing in this season. This is not the time to be distracted. I don't care what's happening. He already told us in Isaiah 60 that darkness covers the earth and thick darkness over the people. He told us that. He's told us to not be distracted. That is the instructions in this hour. Seize the moment and don't become distracted by what is happening in the earth. For this is the set time. And God is declaring to us that we must seize the moment as a ministry. We must seize the moment as people of God. We must seize the moment. Hallelujah. Because this may not happen again. And one thing I wanted to also leave with us, when he started talking to me about opportunities 2 weeks ago, and he told me to look up the definition of opportunity. And as I began to look up the synonyms of opportunity was an opening. It was an opening, right? And we talk about an open heaven. Hallelujah. I believe that we're under an open heaven. Hallelujah. And he started declaring to me about this opportunity. He said, this is an opportunity. My people looking at it as like the enemy. He said, I have allowed it. I allowed the pandemic to bless my people. I have allowed it to, I didn't cause it. I allowed it. I allowed the whole world to shut down so that you can catch up. This is a blessing to the people of God. We gotta catch up to not to what the world is doing, but we must catch up to what God is doing in this hour and in this season. God allowed things to slow down for me so that he could cause me to get things in order for this girl has oil. He said, I allowed you to be home. I've allowed it for you to go home and use this time to do what I've been telling you to do all year. This is the set time. Some of us are home. He said, ask me what I want you to do during in this hour. Is it spend more time seeing what can you put your hands to do for the ministry? We don't got free time to do nothing. This free time should be used to advance the gospel and to advance, hallelujah, God's purpose in the earth. This ain't personal. This is about the kingdom. And our minds have to shift to what God wants to do, hallelujah, for his people. We should be asking the apostle, what do you have in your heart and your mind that God has been placing on you to do in this hour? I got free time now. I've been home. If you've been home watching Netflix, eating snacks, hallelujah, you ain't seizing the moment. Because this may never come again. We may never get this time again. But we got to put our hands to the plow. And the Bible says that we must work while it is yet day, for when night cometh, no man can work. So I just want to leave you with that. Seize the moment. Don't become distracted. Don't let offense take up your heart, because that's what was happening to me. I felt my heart becoming hard. Because I'm like, I waited for this. I prayed for this. God, why is certain things happening? Why are you allowing certain things? And he said, this is not for you to focus. See, your outlook has been wrong. You almost allowed the enemy to steal the joy of the season. You almost allow, hallelujah, not having enough. You almost allow, hallelujah, the attitudes of people to steal this moment. The enemy comes only but to steal, kill, and destroy. He said, but I came that you might have life, and you might have life more abundantly. The scripture still applies even during this time. God came, Jesus came that we might have life, and that we may have life more abundantly. And so in closing, I just want to leave you with, seize the moment. Seize it. Lay hold to it. Hallelujah. So I pray, God, that you would bless, hallelujah, your word today. God, allow it to encourage your people. Allow us, God, to be able to shift our perspective, God, how we view, God, the opposition, God. We view the opposition as being more powerful than what you declared to us, God, at the beginning of 2020. But God, you declared to us that this is the set time, and you have declared to us, God, to seize the moment, Lord God. Father, we pray right now, God, God, that there is an opening happening, God, in regions and in nations, God. God, for the gospel to go forth and be preached. You said in your word that you would not come back, God. So the gospel has been preached in all four corners of the earth, God. So we pray right now, God, we prophesy over our doors. We pray that doors will swing open in this hour. We pray, God, that doors will swing open, God. And we pray, God, that your spirit will be upon these doors, God. Help us, Lord God, to identify our doors when they show up, God. Help us to be able, to identify, God, when doors show up, God, in the ministry, God. Help us to be able to identify, God, what you want to do through your people in this hour and in this season, Lord God. For you declared, Lord God, that the gates of hell shall not prevail against what you want to do in this hour, what you want to do in this season, God. Allow us to be open. And God, I pray that if we have allowed offense, God, from looking at, God, the opposition standing in our way at these doors, God. Father, I pray right now, God, that forgiveness will come upon our hearts, God. If we have allowed disappointment, Lord God, to trample on our faith, God. Father, I declare today, God, that we will look up, that we will look up, that we will look up, God. Let our eyes declare and behold what you're doing in this hour, God. May we behold your goodness in the land of the living, Lord God. May we cut CNN off, God, and may we look up. May we look up, God. Allow your people, God, give us hind feet in the spiritual realm, God, that we will look up, God. We pray right now, God, that we will soar as eagles in this hour and in this season, Lord God. Each and everything that have weighed us down, God, opposition in our home, God, opposition in our family, Lord God. Allow us to look up, God. Allow us to look up, God, in your name, God. Allow us to look up, God, in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Anoint our eyes afresh. Anoint our ears afresh, God, to do what you want to do in this set time, God. And God, we pray, allow us to seize the moment. And it is in Jesus' name that we pray. Amen. Hallelujah. I'd like to turn the service back in the hands of our apostle.
Glory to God. Glory to God. Glory to God. Glory to God. What a word. What a word. What a word. Glory. Glory be to God. Tell somebody it's time to seize the moment. Praise God. And those that are watching us, amen, today by Facebook, I want you to know this time, as she declared that this is the set time of the Lord, amen, to favor us. This is the appointment of the Lord for his people. Glory to God, to not only favor us, but to bless us and to release those things that he's spoken concerning us. So seize the moment. Praise God. Maybe somebody watching us, amen, you've laid hold on it with one hand. Praise God. But I want you to know in this season, it's time to grab hold with both hands and fully commit, amen, to the word and the purposes of God in this season, knowing that this is the time of the Lord for you. Praise God. She talked about that effectual door and many adversaries. I said, like, this is the adversaries that identify your door. Praise God. So that you'll know where you're supposed to go. Praise God. Because there are many doors, but the adversary standing in front of it identifies you that this is the one the Lord wants you to walk into. Praise God. Amen. So, you know, the Bible says that Jesus told the disciples to lift up your eyes and look now at the field, because the harvest is ripe. Amen. And he tells them in Matthew 13 that the field is the world. Praise God. So now when we look at it in Isaiah 60, when he says arise and shine, I want you to know that in Isaiah 60, the darkness is the adversaries that cover the harvest, the world, that you and I are supposed to go into and begin to be the light to shine. Praise God. So don't let the darkness in the world distract you. Let the darkness show you that that is where the harvest is, and that the glorious light of God, the glory of God has risen upon you to enable you and empower you as the breakers anointing to go into the darkness, amen, and recover souls. So praise God. Amen. Thank God again. Amen for Evangelist Von Trees Karsten. What a great word. Seize the moment. Seize the moment. There are times in God where moments will come that if we do not seize the moment, we don't get that moment back. Praise God. So today, everything that God released to you, amen, seize the moment. Take hold of it. Praise God. And I want to just share, amen, maybe somebody that's watching us today that you have not made Jesus Lord over your life. I want to encourage you today to seize the moment. Do not let this moment pass you by. None of us know how long we have to live in this earth. And the Bible declares that all of us, every man, woman, boy, and girl that is born in the earth, that when we leave this earth, that we're going to have to stand before God, our creator, our Father God, who has created everything in the earth. And we're going to have to stand before him to give an account of what we have done in this life, with this life. And I want to ask you a question. If you've not made Jesus Lord over your life, and if today or tomorrow you leave this earth, what answer would you give him when he asks you? I want to just say to you that if God's been dealing with your heart, you know. You say, well, what do you mean? How do I know he's been dealing with my heart? Because when you start realizing, when you look at your life and you see that things that you have desired have not been what you have desired them to be, no matter what you tried to do, you could not make your life better. And you know in your heart that you need to make a change. There's something, there's this voice, the voice on the inside of you that's telling you, you need to do something different. You need to make a change. There's a voice talking to you saying that, you know, there is more. That's the voice of the Lord. That's the voice of the Lord telling you there is more. He says, I know the thoughts that I have concerning you, plans to do you good and not evil, to bring you to an expected end. God has a plan for your life. I know it don't look like it right now. But how you begin to access that life, how you begin to seize the moment is when you begin, when you make the decision to make Jesus Lord over your life. And so if that's you today, I want to offer Christ to you. If that's you, I want you to repeat this prayer with me. Heavenly Father, I come to you in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ. You said in your word that whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. So today, I call on the name of the Lord of Jesus right now. I believe that Jesus died on the cross for my sins, that he was raised from the dead on the third day, and that he is alive right now. Lord Jesus, I'm asking you to come into my heart. I ask you, Lord Jesus, to live your life in me and through me. I repent of all my sins. I denounce my old life, and I surrender myself totally and completely to you. Heavenly Father, by faith, I now confess Jesus Christ as my new Lord and Savior. And from this day forward, I dedicate my entire life to serving you. Amen. If you prayed that prayer, the Bible declares, according to Romans chapter 10, verse 8 through 10, that you are saved. And after making the decision to make Jesus Lord over your life, the next part of your decision is, the Bible says that God will fill you with the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit is the seal who, now that you made this decision, he will come in, fill you, seal you, and empower you to live out this decision that you just made. And so I want to pray for you now, Father, for everyone who has prayed this prayer and received Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior. I pray, Father, that you would baptize them in the Holy Spirit, that not only, Lord God, as they made this decision to make you Lord, but Lord, thank you that the baptism of the Holy Spirit will seal them until the day of redemption. I pray that you would order their steps and lead them into a community of believers that is teaching and preaching you, that they can grow in the knowledge of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. And we thank you for it by faith. In Jesus' name, amen. Praise God. If that's you, amen, please reach out to us and let us know that you have made this decision to make Jesus Lord over your life. Amen. And continue walking with the Lord. Grow. Amen. In God. Amen. Praise God. Read. If you don't have a Bible, buy your Bible. That's one of the best, greatest investments you can make with money. Is if you, when you purchase the word of the Lord, you buy the word of the Lord, because it will always yield eternal rewards. Praise God. So thank you to everyone that's been watching us. Amen. Thank you again. Amen. Providence Kern, amen for the prayer. Amen. Minister Olin for a psalm of praise. Amen. For Evangelist Avantrees Costins for the word of the Lord today. Amen. Thank you to everyone that has joined us. Amen. So before we take our leave, amen, two things I want to do. I want to pray that if you feel moved to sow, amen, praise God. I want you to know that there's nothing that we sow into the kingdom of God that God would not cause you to receive back. And so I want to pray. Father, I thank you for everyone today, that even those that you're moving upon their heart, they feel led to sow into the work of the Lord. Father, you said in your word that when we bring our tithes, firstly, Lord, into your storehouse, that there might be meat in your house, you said that you would rebuke every devourer. And so thank you that every devourer is rebuked. Thank you that there is an open heaven over our lives. Thank you that everyone who is sowing a seed into the work of the Lord, that you will bless their life, Lord, that it will come back to them, pressed down, shaken together, running over, and with good measure, Father, that you will cause them to live in exceeding abundantly above. I thank you, Lord God, and I give you praise for it. In Jesus' name, amen, amen. God bless you again. Thank you, everyone. We love you, amen, with our life, and we pray that you have a phenomenal day. In God, amen, praise God. And so I just decree the word of the Lord over your life today, according to Psalm 84, verse 11. The Lord our God is a sun and shield. He gives us grace and glory. No good thing will he withhold from us because we walk upright before him. May the Lord our God bless you. May he increase you. May he accelerate you. May you be fruitful at everything God has assigned your hand to do. Amen. So be blessed of the Lord, and may the sweet communion of the Holy Spirit rest, rule, and abide with us one and all until we meet again. In Jesus' name. Have a great day in Jesus. Love you all.
Love you all. Have a great day. We're under an open heaven.
Amen. Amen. Hallelujah.
Love you, everyone.
Open heaven, open heaven, open heaven.
Open heaven.
Glory to God. Glory to God. Have a great day, everybody.
Hallelujah.
You too. Bye, family.
Bye-bye.